tour after this, I think. So, and by the way, thanks for the product that you sent over our way. We appreciate it very much. I just want to talk to you a minute about this season. You know, this Christmas season is, it's funny, all the songs are about how, you know, what a wonderful time of year and all that, and it's great, but you know, it's a very difficult time a lot of times. How many of you, this is the first Christmas, you'll go through without, like, a grandmother, grandfather, mother, father? You've lost somebody over the last year, you see me. It'll be the first one. That's tough. And I want you to know my prayers are with you, because having walked through that, it's not the same. But it's okay. God gives you grace to get through it. It's okay. I think Christmas, again, is one of the greatest messages from God that I know. And let me set it up this way. When I was a teenager, when I was in high school, one day I was at home and somebody rang the doorbell. So I go to the door, and there is a beautiful, beautiful package. It has my name. So I'm in high school, and I'm thinking, who would do this? This is rare. Now I don't know what's in it. I'm excited. Man, I pick it up, and I did the first thing. What do you do when you pick up a package? You shake it. I shook it, and it was like something was heavy in there, and it's bouncing all around. I'm like, ooh. Now this is before bottoms were very popular. So I'm like, what is this? And man, I tear into it. It's a rock. I'm saying it's just a rock. And there was this note right there. And the note said this. It's not the gift. It's the thought that counts. And I have no idea who sent it. To this day, I have no idea who sent it. And I'll never forget. It's not the gift. It's the thought. Now, that doesn't always work out when you're giving your wife or your husband a gift. I don't care what the thought is. It could be what it's supposed to be, right? But for me, the question I got to ask is, then what was God thinking when he gave the greatest gift of all? In other words, if I didn't know anything else about him, what would he be saying to me when he gave his son to be born of a virgin? In Bethlehem, on that night. What does that say to us? And I just want to tell you three things God is saying to you. Number one, I love you. There is no greater demonstration of love than God would come down. And remember, Scripture says the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. We do know his glory. The glory of the only begotten Father, full of grace and truth. He is God in the flesh. The fact that God would come down is one of the greatest statements of love ever. No other religion, no other faith, no other even mystery religions of the day have a concept of a God coming down. If you remember much about Greeks, Romans, they had mystery religions. Their gods lived on Mount Olympus. Their gods were up there. You couldn't get to them. They never came down. Our God came down. Maybe. It's a great demonstration of. So if you don't hear anything else this Christmas, if you don't realize what all the things are about and everything, just hear this. It's God literally saying from the heavens, I love you enough that I came to where you are. The second thing, I forgive you. Now this one is huge. I forgive you. What does it mean that God would come, that God would give his son? For me, it is a statement of God's desire to take away my sin, to forgive. You see, when you've done something, and you're kind of at odds with somebody, or you've done something to hurt them, or you're kind of in debt to them, they can stand back, and they can kind of wait for you to come bowing down and all. In other words, the tendency is for us to make people pay for their sin. And so we kind of exact revenge by just the way we treat them. And we don't offer forgiveness and we don't offer anything until they come crawling back to us. That's typically how we deal with things. Think about this. While we were yet sinners, God didn't wait on us to come. He didn't wait on us to come and say, we messed up, mankind is sinful. He took the initiative, gave his son. So if anything, that's God saying to me, I forgive you and I'm going to take the first step to try to make it right. And he did. In fact, he gave me the only way you can remember, and that is through his son. So I will always think of Christmas as this great declaration that God has forgiven us. And I will say it this way, he has made it available in his son. Another thing God is saying is, I understand. People all the time tell me, Pastor, you don't understand what I'm going through. The truth is, I don't. I mean, there's no way you can understand what your friend's going through. Those of you who raised your hand a minute ago that have had a loss, we don't know what you're going through. You say, well, I've lost somebody. Yeah, but every relationship is different. Pain is unique. We don't all share the same kind of pain. We share pain, but we don't share the same kind. But let me tell you why I think Christmas is a message saying, I understand. He put on himself flesh just like you and I were, and he was tempted in every way like we are. So though I may not understand your temptations, your struggles, he understands everyone. Because let me show you something that kind of revolutionized my thinking when I thought about this, all right? Let's say I got a meter here. All right, this is on this side is red line, way over here. All right, here's zero. Whenever you and I get tempted, all the enemy has to do, all that temptation has to do is crank it up just a little bit. And we fall. Some of you, maybe a little stronger than others, crank it on up. Crank it on up. Not a person has ever walked on this earth since. Everybody has fallen at some point when that meter was going up. There have been some great people. I mean, Steve, man, meter goes way up here. He's a great guy, but I've seen the fall, so it happens, all right? Okay, now watch this. So no man has ever lived past, has ever walked with integrity and without sin past a certain point on this. There is any message you hear this Christmas. I want you to hear this. He understands. He's been here. He was crucified. As he walked among us. None of us have faced that. He was crucified. So there's nothing you will ever go through or I will ever go through that he doesn't understand. So this incredible message from Christmas is not that we got a rock room. No. We got God himself. The greatest gift of all. But we also got a message. And the message was, I love you. I forgive you. I understand. So I pray that you will hear those words as you celebrate the birth of our King, the birth of the Lord Jesus. However you celebrate Christmas, whatever your tradition is, whatever your faith background is, I just pray somewhere along the way, you'll remember something that God says to you at Christmas time. And may the Lord bless you. May the Lord fill your home and your life with peace. And may you know the joy that Jesus brings, and the peace on earth through the angels. God bless you guys, and Merry Christmas. Have a blessed day.